So hello and welcome to Rotary English Medium School. I hope you all are fine and taking care of your health. Speaking about our school, Rotary School can't direct the wind, but we are always there to navigate you ashore. So I would like to start my teaching with a quote, "A mind is like a parachute. It doesn't work if we do not open it." And I would like all the students, and I would like to request especially to all my students that please open your mind and listen to the video. So now moving towards our next topic of Vistas, "Should Wizard Hit Mommy?" which is written by John Updike. So now let us know about the author. So John Updike, he was very famous. He is from America. He was born on March 18 and he died on January 27, 2009. He was famous poet, he was famous writer, and he was very creative writer. So he had won n number of prizes, and the special prize which he had won was Pulitzer Prize, which he won in 1982 for his writing in Rabbit in Rich. And the second prize which he won was 1990 for Rabbit at Rest. He was only the writer who had won Pulitzer Prize for more than once. So now moving towards our story, with the title you can understand, "Should Wizard Hit the Mommy?" So you can understand that Wizard and Mommy are the characters in the story. You all have heard n number of stories about Wizard. Wizard is specially known for its magics, and Mommy, you might be knowing that everybody knows that how the mommy is, how much careful she is. So let's see what is there in our story. So here, if we talk about the story, this is the story about a 4-year child. Her name is Jaw, and she, while narrating the story, she asked, with her inquisitiveness, she asks her father a lot of questions, where father feels stuck somewhere and he is not able to reply her in a proper way. So here we will see the story about a worldview of a little child and very difficult question, moral question, which she raises during the story session. So worldview of a little child means that little child, she is in her dream world. We all know that when you all were small, you all might have listened to the bedtime stories, you all might have listened to the fantasy stories. So these students or these children are always dream about the stories which they listen. And here the problem arises with the father is that whether that child has to take it up morally or whether the child has to get the happy ending. So here when we will move ahead, we will understand that what the topic is about. So moving towards our topic, please open your textbook, read the first paragraph, pause the video, and once you will read it, please listen to the explanation. So here, moving towards our first paragraph, before that I would like to give the introduction of the characters. The characters in the story is Jack, who is the father of Jaw. Jaw's full name is Joanne, and she has one brother who is 2 years old, and her mother's name is Claire. Here father is narrating the story, which is the custom followed since Jaw was 2 years old. And here we will see that while creating the story, how the father creates different portraits of the character and how he tries to explain this thing to the Jaw. So here you can see that every evening and Saturdays, this Jack was having the habit of giving the different stories or telling the different stories. And same thing, the same custom was followed when she was 2 years old, as we have discussed before. So in his story, every time there was one character whose name was Roger, and he used to change the characters with the small creatures like Roger Fish, Roger Squirrel, Roger's Chipmunk. So the main character's name given by the Jack was Roger. Then there was a same plot, same concept, and the story would go ahead. This Roger character would have some problems. That problem was taken to the wise old owl, and that owl would ask them to go to wizard. So once that character goes to the wizard, he does some magic things, and then that problem used to get solved. But then wizard used to ask them for some pennies, which was little bit extra. So every time whenever he asks him for the pennies, and if the character he used to give some target, he used to give some work, and when that work get finished, the story would end with a happy ending. So this is the narration of the story which every time Jack used to tell. So these are the characters which Jack used to tell every time in the stories: Roger Fish, Wise Owl, Roger Chipmunk, Roger Squirrel. And this story which we are going to do it now is Roger Skunk. So here I have especially given these two pictures, Roger Squirrel and Roger Chipmunk. Actually, there is very slight variation. Everyone knows about squirrel, but everyone feels that this is also a squirrel, but actually chipmunk has a stripes on their body, and so Roger Chipmunk. So chipmunk is different and squirrel is different. And especially about skunk, skunk is famous for his bad smell. And here in future you will see that in the story the problem which is going to arise is about the smell. Here the bad smell is the positive thing for skunk, because the animals do not go near him and they are saved by the predators. So let's move ahead and see what is the next. Okay, continuing with the story, we should see that once the things are fine, or when the characters get their problem solved, what happens that he plays many games with the creatures, then he goes home with his mother, and then they wait, they have a supper, and they wait for the father to come from Boston. So this is the story. Now here Jack described that supper and the story was over. So working this way through this scheme was especially fatiguing on the Saturdays. Why it is written here? Because you all have seen that when Jaw was 2 years old, the tradition was started of telling the story, and Jack would tell the story out of his head. Now his mind was unable to create new stories, and now he used to feel very fatigued telling the stories, because with these stories Jaw would never get asleep, and it was very difficult for job for him. Now once again, please read this paragraph. Once you will read it, pause the video and then you just listen to the explanation. So if you will go through this paragraph, you can see here that the author has described about the little girl. Who is that little girl? How they have described about the little girl? Here you can see that no, so little anymore. The bumps her feet made under the covers were halfway down the bed. Their big double bed that they let her be in for naps and when she was sick. So if you will read, you will not understand this. What is the meaning of this? They want to say that the girl is little, but she is not so little, because they had double bed where she used to sleep when she used to get sick. But that double bed was now not fitted for her, because her feet used to come out of that bed. So now author is describing she is little, but she is not 2 years old. Now she is 4 years old, and there is a difference in thinking level of that age. So if we will think about the little girl, had at last arranged herself, and from the way her fat face deep in the pillow shone in the sunlight sifting through the drawn shades, it did not seem fantastic that some magic word would occur and she would take her nap like an infant of 2. So here author says that once she was sleeping on the bed, there was the shade of the sun which was covering her face, and there was the means, if you will see the curtain, there are some of the rays of sunlight which goes and pass through and it comes on the face. So same thing author is trying to describe us, that even though the pillow was there, The sun rays were spread on her face, and from anywhere it was not able to see that she is going to get asleep. So here, if she would be 2 years old, she would have got asleep. But now, as she was 4 years, it was difficult for her to get asleep, because now her inquisitiveness was increased, her curiosity was increased. So it was difficult for Jack to make her sleep. So here her brother Bobby was 2, as now it is compared that as he was 2 years old, he got asleep early with his bottle. Now here, now the Jack starts his story. So Jack asks her daughter, Jack asks his daughter that what shall the story about? And suddenly Jaw screamed her eyes, squeezed her eyes, and suddenly she is very happy, and suddenly she says that it should be skunk. So now Jack feels that maybe now she is going to nursery school and she has learned about this animal, and now let us take that character and start the story. So he starts the story with great enthusiasm. Okay, all right, he said, and now the story starts. So he says that once upon a time, in a dark wood forest, there was a tiny little creature named Roger Skunk. So his story starts with the name of character Roger Skunk. And what was his feature? What was his problem? That he smelled very bad. Now, yes, Jaw said, he smelled so bad that none of the other little woodland creatures would play with him. So here, further, Jack says that he was so bad that no other creatures would come near to him. Jaw looked at him solemnly. She hasn't foreseen this. So here, you can see that as soon as the story will go ahead, the flow will go ahead, you can see that Jaw used to feel each and every creatures in herself, and if she used to create emotions, because she used to connect it with herself. As her age, she is unable to understand that what the problems are there outside. She was in her dream world and she feels that everyone should be happy. So whenever any problem arises, Jaw used to feel bad. So when she heard that smell was so bad, she felt very bad, and with deep sincerity she started listening to it. And then ahead, when father says that when he would go out to play, while speaking, suddenly when he told that he wanted to play, suddenly Jack thought about his humiliation, or when he was child, he thought that it would happen sometimes with him as well. So with his thinking, he starts the story, goes with the story, and he himself feels that he is the character. And while telling, he says that they used to call him like Roger Stinky Skunk. So Stinky Skunk, when Jaw listens to that, the tears roll down from her eyes, because the same thing happened with the Roger Skunk. And so it was very difficult for her to adjust that Roger Skunk is unhappy. So here further we can see that she was so curious that she wanted that the problem should get resolved very early. So as soon as she came to know about the problem, she interferes in between while telling the story, and she asks, won't he see the owl? And she was very curious that Roger Skunk should go as fast as possible to owl, because she was knowing the story, and she was knowing that when that character will go to owl, definitely he is going to get some or other way. So she asked in a high and roughened voice. Sitting on the bed beside her, Jack felt the covers tug as her legs switched tensely. Now you can see that she was tense. She was waiting that when that character will go, and same way she asked her father. He was pleased with this moment. He was telling her something true, something she must know, and had no wish to hurry on. But here, if you will see about the Jack was thinking about his humiliation, and he wanted that she should know that what problems are faced in a real life, and so he did not want to hurry, and he wanted that Jaw should have patience and she should listen to him in a proper way. So then Jack started the story, and already the story was of Roger Skunk, who was living in the forest. And then they started, he went to play, but there was no other creatures who would like to play with him due to his bad smell. So these things are there, explanation is there in this. Okay, now further what happened while telling the story, one more thing was going on, that Claire, his wife, she was 6 months pregnant, and so even though they both were actually painting prior before telling the story, but as Joe was having habit to listen to the story, so Jack has to go and explain or narrate the story to her. So here Claire was alone working, and there he comes to know that she is working alone, and he should get down and help the Claire to paint the living room. But well, he walked alone very sadly, and then here again he comes to his story, and then he says that Roger Skunk walked alone very sadly and came to a very big tree. And in the tip top of the tree, there was an enormous wise old owl. So how nicely, expressively he's trying to tell. He wants that Joe should experience this, and he should and she should understand that what the problems are faced by everyone. So she wanted, so same thing he told, that slowly he was very sad. He didn't like as creatures were not playing with him. So slowly he goes to a big tree, and there was a tip top of the tree, means at the top of the tree, enormous wise old owl. So he was a very big old owl. "Good, Mr. Owl," Roger Skunk said, "all the other little animals run away from me because I smell so bad." So Mr. Owl says, "Okay, you have come here," and he shares his problem, that what was his problem, as no animal would like his smell, so everybody would run away. Then Owl, with very sad voice, he says, "Very, very bad." But then he asks that what can he do for him. So Roger Skunk said, and he cried very hard. He says, "Wizard." Now here what happens, that the story was moving ahead, but once again Joe was not having that patience to wait, because she wanted that the problem should get resolved very fast. And so in between again she interrupts and says, wizard, and shouts and sits right up. Now she was very much interested that when that Roger Skunk will go to Wizard. And so in between once again she interferes and interrupts the Jack. So now Jaw, Daddy is telling the story. Do you want to tell Daddy the story? So now here somewhere Daddy tells, means Jack says, that I am telling you the story. If you don't want to listen, then you narrate me the story. No, she tells, you continue. And then once again she lies down, and then her head is relaxed onto the pillow, and she said, "Out of your head." Well, the owl thought and thought. At last he said, "Why don't you go to see the wizard?" "Daddy, what? Are magic spells real?" Now here, when he speaks about the wizard, suddenly she realizes about the magic, because she knows that once Roger Skunk will go to wizard, definitely he will do some magic. So here once again she asks that, "Are magic spells real?" So see, we can see that how curious the kids are, and in between always they interrupts and they want to know that what is the reason behind it. And so we can see with the story that every time this kid is interrupting in middle, and Jack is feeling very difficult to give the answer. So let's see what he has given the answer. Okay, now here author is explaining that this was a new phase, just this last month a reality phase. So here what author wants to say, that now as she has started going, she is trying to know the world, so there are so many new things she wants to learn. So when he told her before some days, when he told about the spider bugs, spider eat bugs, she once again asked her mother, "Really, do spider eat bugs?" And same thing when Claire told her that God was in the sky and all around them, she turned to her father. So she was always curious to ask everything. When mother used to tell her some point of view, she would not believe her. And she used to go and try to ask the same question to others, and she used to ask. Means if mummy tells, then she used to go to father. If father asks, then she used to go to mummy. And same thing, she would never believe. She would still try to eager to ask that really that things happens or not. See, you have seen that many times when you go to the nursery classes, at that age students are very much eager and anxious to know so many things. They ask that why birds fly, why grass is green, or why sky is blue. So many different type of questions they ask, and sometimes parents feel very difficult to give the answers, because at that age it is not possible that parents can try to explain their kids in a proper way. So same thing it happens, and at last she turned to her father and asked, and father says no, they are real in stories. So he is trying to explain that it's not real in our life. The things which are there, they are real in stories, because he is not having the proper answer. So either he says yes or no, or sometimes he gets angry. So let's see that what's next in the paragraph. The owl said, now once again they come in the story, and let's see the flow. So when he reaches to the owl, owl suggests him that he should go through the dark woods under the apple trees into the swamp over the creek. So here once again you can see the flow goes on. So owl suggests him to go to the watery place, there he will find the creek. So here suddenly once again she asks, what's a creek? A little river over the creek, and there will be the wizard's house. And that's the way Roger Skunk went. And pretty soon he came to a little white house, and he rapped on the door. So he knocked on the door. Let's see what happens next. Then Jack rapped on the windowsill, and under the covers, Jo's tall figure clenched in an infantile thrill. So now she was very much eager to see. So when Jack just knocked, to show that effects, he just knocked on the windowsill to show that he has knocked the door. And under the covers, Jo's figure was just clenched. She was just waiting that what is going to happen next. And then a tiny little old man came out for what she was waiting for. She wanted that he should solve the problem at the earliest. And so with a long white beard and a pointed blue hat, say, hey, what's this? What you want? You smell so awful. The wizard's voice was one of the Jack's own favorite effects. He did it by scrunching up his face. He used to tighten his face with the jaw, and he used to bring that effect. According to him, because last 2 years he was telling the story, and his characters would be same. So he was habituated of bringing those characters in his voice. But the favorite one was wizard. So he used to do it very beautifully. And so same thing author has explained us in a proper way, that he brought that character in him and which Jo would like the best. Then Jack felt that this character suited him, so he used to enjoy that character. Then if we move towards the story, what happens? Roger Skunk said that what was his problem. He says that all the little animals run away from him and nobody plays with him. So this was the problem which he shared with wizard. And so while telling that, he told okay, and he asked him that, can you help me? So maybe. So he agrees that he will help him. Come on in, don't get too close. But he says, okay, you can come, but you don't come too close to me. And now inside Jo, there were all magic things. So he explains that as soon as he entered the house, he saw all the magic things inside, and all together were big dusty heap. So everywhere the things were scattered, and there was a heap of all the things where you cannot find the proper way. And if you want to find some other things, it was very difficult to find, because the house was not clean. It was very dusty. And so character, he asks that why there would be so much dust in the house. So as father says that as wizard was not having old lady, he was alone and he was old, so he was unable to clean the house. So suddenly while she listens that he was old, she suddenly asks that will he die, because she was knowing that when the people get old, people die. So suddenly she was curious to ask, will he die? So further father says, no, wizards never die. So once again she was happy. Well, he rummaged around a found and he then found a old stick called a magic wand. So at last father says that anyhow he tried to manage to get that stick. And then he find the magic wand and asks the Roger's conch that what type of smell he wants. Roger thought and thought and suddenly he said, I want the smell of roses. Then he says, good. Jaw said smugly. Means she was very happy. And Jack fixed her with a trance-like gaze and chanted in the wizard, elderly, irritable voice. So here, author says that Jack tries to bring that character of wizard and he tries to speak in his irritable voice. So what was that? Abracadabra, hocus po, Roger Skunk, how do you do? Roses, boses, pull an ear, Roger Skunk, you never fear. Bingo! So once these things were told, suddenly the problem was solved. So let's see what happens next. Then he paused at a rapt expression widened out from his daughter's nostrils, forcing her eyebrows up and her lower lip down in a wide, noiseless grin, an expression in which Jack was startled to recognize his wife feigning pleasure at cocktail parties. What do you mean by this sentence? Here you can see that after speaking, he stopped his rapt expression and he was able to see her daughter so happy. She had widened her eyebrows and she was so excited because the problem was solved. And at that time, he remembers that whenever his wife gets cocktail party, the same happiness he was able to see on Jaw's face. And all of a sudden, he whispered. The whole inside of the wizard's house was full of smell of roses, roses. Roger Fish cried. And the wizard said very cranky, that will be 7 pennies. Daddy, what? Roger Skunk. So now here you can see that father by chance makes the mistake. By mistake he says Roger Fish instead of Roger Skunk. So here she tries to correct her father and she says that it should be Roger Fish. So daddy casually says, okay, Roger Skunk. But she tells that no, he should not do such type of silly mistakes while speaking. So how stupid my daddy is, like that she expresses her views. And then once again, he was disturbed in his story. And then he asks Jaw that where he was. And then again, he starts with the story. Okay, Roger Skunk said, but all I have is 4 pennies. Now, Roger Skunk was having only 4 pennies and wizard has demanded 7 pennies. So now here once again there was a problem and that problem was to be resolved. But this time without a trace of sincerity, she was unable. So here you can see that she was going ahead of Jack and Jack did not like it. So Jack was getting annoyed and he was getting angry because as she was not showing any patience to Jack. So, once again, you can see that while telling the story, Jack's mind sometimes used to go to Claire as well. So, once again, he can see that the furniture rumbled and it disturbed him and he thought that Claire is working there and she is taking all the heavy things which she shouldn't do as she is pregnant. But again, he moves towards the story and he says, Wizard says, oh, very well, go to the end of the land, turn around 3 times and look down the magic well, there you will find 3 pennies. So this was the thing which wizard has told. So Roger Skunk goes to that land and then he takes 3 rounds and then he see that what is there in the well and suddenly he found 3 pennies and he was very happy. Same thing, these 3 pennies he gives to wizard and now he is very happy. After coming out from the wizard's house, he moves towards all his friends and his friends all gather near him and they like the smell of the roses. And then that day he plays a lot of games like baseball, play tag, football, baseball, lacrosse, hockey, saucer and pickup sticks. So while telling the story, now once again Jaw interrupts Jack and says, what do you mean by pickup sticks? It's a game you play with stick, he answers. But is it like the wizard's band? So she asks, she wants to know that what is the meaning of that and what type of sticks it is. So then at last when she asks wizard's band, so he replies, yes, it's the same like a wizard's magic wand. And then they played the games, laughed together, and then when it began to dark, they all went to home to their mommies. Now, as you all know that Roger Skunk was very happy, and he reached and he talked with her, with his mom. So listening to this, Jo was very happy, and she started fussing her hands and all, and she shows so much excitement that she thought that now the story was over. But this Jack did not like at all, because he feels that women should not underestimate the things. And so he told that Jo should not take all the things to grant. And then hanging on his words, he told that, Jo, are you listening to me or not? I am going to tell you something interesting. So once again, he wanted Jo to bring in the story, and he wanted that Jo should listen to him. And so further moving towards the story, he says that Roger Skunk's mummy said, "What's that awful smell? What's that?" And Roger Skunk says, "It's me, mommy. I am smelling like roses." So here you can see the expression, because every time Jo had the habit to end the story with a happy ending. But here you can see that mommy did not like the problem which was solved by wizard. And so she tells that this rosy smell was very awful. Then she asks that, who made you smell like that? So he replies that wizard had changed the smell. So she was so angry and furious. So she told him to take back that awful smell, and she wanted that her child should smell like how he was before. And so she tells Roger Skunk that she wanted to meet the wizard, and she wanted that wizard should change his rosy smell to his original smell. Now, all right, he said, but mommy, all the other little animals run away. So what was his problem? That due to his bad smell, animals would not play with him. But today, but that day, when the wizard changed his smell with the roses, all the animals had played with him and all were happy, and he was happy. But in the written, mummy tells that, I don't care, you smell the way a little skunk should be. Because she wanted that was the feature which was given by the nature, and that should be accepted by Roger Skunk. And so at last she took the umbrella, and she took Roger Skunk with her, and then she tells that she wants to meet the wizard. And when she went to wizard, she told wizard that she wanted to change the smell of roses to his original smell. But she was so angry that she, with her umbrella, she bit wizard, and this was not liked at all by the Jo. Jo was very angry. She did not like this, and dad not tell you anymore. She told that, why dad? It means she showed her bad expressions, and then her broad face looked at him through shifted light. Miss, at last here in story you can understand that they are showing the expression, and here you can see that daddy, why such type of ending? Then he says that this is daddy's story and you should listen to daddy. So now what happened, that when Roger Skunk and his mommy went home, now what happened before that, Roger Skunk, once again wizard changed the smell, and again he became the same how he was before. And then mommy and Roger Skunk went home. And then now here again he tries to bring that story which he used to tell before. And he says that they heard woo 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 train and choo choo train, who was bringing our daddy Skunk home from Boston. So same the story was trying to be end. Here he wants to show that the story is end, means whatever the problem was, he want to keep that problem the same, and he wants that Jo should accept the same. And so at last he says that they had lot of stuff in their supper, like lima beans, celery, liver, mashed potatoes, pie. And then she feels that the story should be different. But here Roger Skunk was in the bed, and again ahead when Jack goes ahead and he says that when mother makes to try Roger Skunk sleep, she says that mom will never think wrong about you. And she hugged him and said he smelled like her little baby once again. And so Jack wanted that Joe should accept that whatever the things are there in front of them, she should accept it the way they are. And she should listen to the parents as well. Now here was an evil shade, but here you can see that Joe did not like at all the ending which was given by the Jack. She feels that the mother was evil, mother was the villain of the story, and she wanted that father should change the story. And so she told that mommy as a stupid. She told that this was a stupid mommy. Innocently she said she did not realize that what she is talking about mommy. But for her, here mommy was not good because Roger Skunk was not happy. For the whole story, if you can see that the problem arised was of bad smell, and here once again he has got that bad smell, and she thinks that now the animals will not play with him. So it was not he said, what rare emphasis is now again she changes her expressions, and now he told that now I want you to put your big heavy head in the pillow. So here when the Jack ended the story, he wanted that Josh should end the story and Josh should sleep, and she should not argue for the ending of the story. But here you can see that Joy is always disturbing him, and she feels that the ending which father has given is not correct, and he adjusted the shade so not even a crack of a day showed, and tiptoed to the door in the pretense, and she was already asleep. Now here he feels she means whatever every time he used to do and adjust the bed and everything, so he did everything, and then he felt that she is asleep. But when he turned, she was crouching out of the covers, top of the covers, so slightly she was watching her father, and he realized that she was staring at him. Now once again father was furious, and she says, get under the cover and fall fast asleep. Bob is asleep, same thing you have to do, as your brother is asleep you should sleep. Now he was very annoyed, he wanted that Joe should sleep, but now here the problem was Joe was not ready at all to sleep, because here there was a problem with the Joe. She found that the characters which father used to tell the story used to be having happy ending, but here she feels that father has not ended the story very well. So once again she tells daddy, what tomorrow? She told that tomorrow will you change the story, and will you tell that wizard took that magic wand and hit that mommy? So once again she tells the father that please you change the story, and she wanted that wizard should hit mommy. No, that's not the story. He tells, no, I am not going to change the story. The point is that little skunk loved his mommy more than he loved all the little animals. So here he wants that Joe should understand that friends are not more important, parents are more important, because here he has brought into our consideration that even though friends are important, but sometimes whenever they have to think about the parents and friends, mother or father will think more better than the friends, because friends are of the same age, they do not have that maturity, but parents have experience, parents have maturity. And so he wants that to understand that he loved his mummy very much, and so he is happy with this. But Joe feels that somewhere Roger Skunk was unhappy. So now once again here she says, father please change the story, and she is not ready to sleep. And then when Jack feels that he should go down and see, so once again she tells, please go to the sleep, you are a good girl. And then he closed the door and he goes out. When he comes out, he sees that Claire was doing work, even though she was working alone. He saw that some things were painted ivory, but still some were tan. But while coming down again, he understood that Joy is following him, and then so once again he says, Jack says to Joy that now surely she has to go for the sleep, otherwise he was going to spank him, otherwise he will beat up her. So she wanted He wanted that Joe should accept the story as it was told by him, and Joe wanted that Dad should change the story, but neither of them were ready to compromise with it. At last, as Joe was a very small girl, she had to listen to father, and he forcefully made Joe to go inside and sleep. And then he comes down, he see the things, the situation, and here you can see that the story ends where Jack was very much tired, he was very much fatigued. He was knowing that his wife is working alone, but he did not speak with her, he did not work with her, or he did not touch her, because he wanted to sit silent, because he was little bit angry with the Joe as she was not trying to understand him. And this way the story is ended, and here you can see that author has tried to make us understand that there are two perspectives, where you can see the parents' perspective and where you can see the children's perspective. So please change the slide. Here see, the story raises the moral question of whether parents always understood what is best for their children, or if the child in question deals with the situation by himself or herself, which the parent might not be able to comprehend. See here, there are two big visions which we need to understand. Both of them are correct. Parents are also correct and kids are also correct. But somewhere we can see that parents are more experienced, and parents feel that till they are secured with the parents, kids are always supportive, or kids are always supported by the parents. But when they have to face the harsh reality of the life, it will be difficult for them. So sometimes parents have to be very strict with their kids. But on the other hand, kids are in their own world. They feel that whatever they do is always correct, and they feel that parents do not understand them. So this is the ending of the story, and here author has kept for the reader to think that should wizard hit mommy. So this title has very deep meaning, where you have to take a choice and you have to decide whether father was correct or whether the child was correct. So here both of them were correct according to us, but somewhere parents should understand that what the problems of the kids are, and sometimes kids also should listen to the parents. So this is the gap which they have to bring it near. And as this story is about the parent, this is my view to all of you. It is my request to all of you that as a teacher or as a parent, I want to tell you all that whatever your parents are doing is for your betterment. No one can love more than your parents. So at least sometimes when you feel that your parents are wrong, please rethink it twice and then talk to your parents. They will definitely understand you. And with this, I would like to end my session. So thank you for watching it. And once again, I would like to thank all of you. Thank you.